Now let us study about the path of projectile. Suppose a body is projected up with an initial velocity u. A body has been thrown up with an initial velocity u in a direction making an angle theta naught with the horizontal. Let O be the point of projection. That means we start the projection from here. O be the point of projection. And OX and OY are the horizontal and vertical axis. Now, resolving U. In vectors, we have seen that we are resolving any motion into two parts. Okay, the horizontal and the vertical. The horizontal and the vertical components we are taking as UX, that is the horizontal component, as U cos theta, and UY, the vertical component, as U sin theta. Now, the angle is always made by the horizontal component. Okay, so whichever resolution vector is making an angle with the main direction of the velocity or motion, that will be taken as your horizontal component. So UX is equal to U cos theta naught and UY is equal to U sin theta naught. These are the horizontal and vertical components of this velocity U, which is projected at an angle of theta by the horizontal. The body moves under constant gravitational acceleration G, acting vertically downwards. The horizontal velocity ux remains unchanged throughout the motion. Ux apni jagah same rahegi, but uy continuously changes because the direction is changing continuously. The displacement of the body along the horizontal direction after time t, that is, we are taking the horizontal displacement as x, will be equal to the displacement or the distance will be equal to horizontal velocity into time, which is given as x is equal to u cos theta naught into t, or the time will be x upon u cos theta naught. Right. Now, the displacement along the vertical component. So, the vertical displacement, that is the displacement along vertical component, can be given as vertically kitna displacement, that is what I has again, h is equal to ut minus half gp square. Now this velocity is the vertical velocity. When you are considering the height, we are taking the vertical velocity and we write it as the vertical displacement we are taking as y, u we are taking as u sin theta naught into t minus half gp square. Okay, so this is equation 2, and as we have taken out the value of t from 1 and 2, we have y is equal to u sin log t, u sin log t. From equation number 1 in equation number 2. So u sin theta naught into t. So t ki jagah x upon u cos theta naught minus half gt square. So x upon u cos naught square. So when you are opening it, this becomes sin upon cos u gets cancelled out. Tan theta minus half g x square u square cos square theta. The only thing is we are writing it in a way of an equation, that is x tan theta minus half g u square cos square theta x square. Now, Chinmay, I want to tell you one thing, that this type of equation, what kind of shape it is showing. For example, when we are writing y is equal to mx plus c, you very well know that this equation denotes a straight line. You have done it in class 10. Similarly, an equation which is linear in x and quadratic in y, this type of equation shows a parabola. This equation is representing a parabola. And so mathematically we say that this path which has been taken by an object which is projected at an angle of theta with a velocity u is a parabola. The only reason you need to write it, for biology students I'll say you learn this statement, and for math student I expect you to know it, that an equation which is linear in x and quadratic in y is denoting a parabola, and hence this path is a parabola. So if you are asked to prove that the path of a projectile is a parabola, you are expected this derivation. After that, you'll be seeing the height, the time taken, the horizontal range covered. All these are a part of projectile. I hope this point is clear to you.